Accessing mineral deposits is often made very difficult these days because of the sheer depth of the minerals and where they exist. Shaft Sinkers is a company that brings solutions to mining businesses in an engineering format, and the chief executive is Alon Davidov, who joins us now. Alon, welcome.
Thanks, Jeremy.
Very interesting area of operation. Give us some more detail about precisely what it is you do and the processes involved in this.
Well, Jeremy, you correctly said that this is a specialist field, deep mining, ultra-deep mining, in fact, and it starts with a very long process in tendering, in understanding what the client actually requires to do. This is highly capital-intensive type of projects, critical path infrastructure for the mining houses to access their ore bodies at incredible depths and in a certain time frame. And we are the companies that, a handful of companies that do this. Typically takes anything from 6 to 12 months to prepare for a tender. Once we're awarded, it takes anything up to 12 months to site establish. And depending on the depth of the project and all the technical specification and the geology that we have to take into consideration, it may take up to 7 years to actually complete a shaft system for a client to start operating and extracting ore.
Are there many competitors in this space?
There are not that many competitors. There are probably just over a handful of companies that do this. We virtually always meet each other, and there's a lot of work out there, so you know the competition is there, but it's not that intense.
What about the funding of these things? I imagine very highly capital intensive, large pieces of very expensive machinery, doubtless.
Well, let me give you an example. On average, it will probably cost £100 million to sink a 1 kilometer shaft. Today, we're dealing with shafts in excess of 2 kilometers. So this is the type of areas that you're looking at. The equipment and the key part of it are winders, which for the benefit of our viewers is huge lift motors, 2,500 horsepower machines. They cost anywhere between 6 to 8 million pounds, and they take 18 months to manufacture. So the way we structure our projects is that we actually receive an advance payment to enable us to purchase some of this or refurbish some of this key plant and equipment and not have to fund it ourselves per se.
Typically, what sort of percentage are you talking about?
We're looking at about a 10% advance typically on these projects.
Cash flow is down. Why is this and can you improve it?
Our cash flow is dependent, because of the mechanism that I've just explained, on the start of projects. Our projects have a specific cash flow profile to them. They typically have high cash requirements in the beginning and then they taper off. Our cash flow has gone down towards the end of last year and this year because of the delay in an award of a contract that we're happy to now announce, and we've announced it in April. We've been awarded a major contract in India, which will now see our cash flow spike significantly, and this is because of the nature that I've just explained. We've also been investing in our international activity in setting up offices in the CIS and India, mm-hmm. in order to diversify. This is our stated mission when we listed: diversify our skill set and our service ability to different regions as well as mineral deposits.
I believe you've got about £1 billion worth of tenders out there, I think is around about that sort of figure, isn't it? What's the split between South Africa and international business, as you call it?
I think the figure might be a little bit less now because we've been awarded a major contract in India that we've announced, but it will soon be replenished at the activity that we're seeing. The split, I would say, is probably about 30% South Africa and 70% international, which is where we want to be. We are heavily focused on getting business outside of South Africa in order to achieve our stated goals.
What about the size of the order book at the moment?
We last released that figure in April. It was about £400 million. roundabout there. So it would be a little bit less right now.
Outside of all this, it's been well headlined that the contract you had with Eurochem came to a premature end, and shareholders were particularly concerned because of the size of this project against the rest of the book. Are there any costs or drags still to come from the winding down of this?
Well, we've shown our exposure. Mm-hmm. We've shown it in our previous results, last results. And I expect it to remain at that level. There's still a little bit of costs involved in the demobilization of our key equipment. And we're currently still in discussions with the client around final settlement of accounts. So I don't see any further increase in our exposure.
You mentioned the last set of accounts. So that showed a dividend, an annual dividend there of 7.2 pence, which I think is what a yield on about 8.5% or so. Yeah. Challenge anybody to find anywhere else you're going to get those sort of percentages at the moment. But what's your dividend strategy going forward? I mean, I know Kevin Fogarty at Westhouse Securities is expecting a repeat of that sort of level for this full year.
Yes, Jeremy, we've stated this is our policy to pay out 2 to 3 cover on earnings, and we feel comfortable that we will achieve that. And I think you quite rightly said that today this is an excellent yield, and we're comfortable. We'll have the cash cover, the earnings cover to continue doing so.
What about the share price? I mean, small cap stocks have been hit. We constantly repeat this in many of the interviews that we do, and Shaft Sinkers is no exception. It's about 70 pence at the moment. Again, going back to Westhouse Securities, they've got a strong buy recommendation and a target of 170 pence. How does that sit with you as the chief executive of the company? I mean, how do you feel about the outlook for the business and achieving those sort of goals?
Well, I think that 70 pence for our company is unreasonably low. That's my personal view. We're very bullish about the outlook of the company, and I think that you'll see some good things as soon as we have some more news to come, you know.
Well, we hope there are more of those contract wins you were talking about earlier in the interview, but Alon, in the meantime, thanks for joining us and explaining about Shaft
Sinkers.
Thanks
for the opportunity.
That was Alon Davidov, the chief executive there of Shaft Sinkers.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.